Hello again. Thought I would do something a little different, but I implore you to pay attention. This may be one of the most significant things that you would become aware of. And the reality is that you're already aware of it because you're using it all the time. There is not a moment, sleeping or awake, that you're not using a particular mechanism within yourself, your life, and your relationships to others. Now, this for me, the reason I'm doing this is I'm in the middle of the third month of autumn. The third month is obviously a sequence of 3 months. The first month I went through was September to October. That's the first month of autumn. Each one of these little balls just represents a different month. They also have a whole bunch of other meanings about them, such as each one of these balls is a point in my feminine existence or mirrored in my family tree with three different grandmothers: mother's mother, mother's mother's mother, and mother's father's mother. These are glands, organs, body systems reflected inside of me, but they're also instruments of my existence and progress. One of them has to do with feeling self. It's inalienable. No matter what you do, you will be doing this one all the time. You're feeling. It's not just the emotional content of what you're feeling right now about yourself, your life, your body chemistry, the world around you. There is an instrument here that has to do with the actual experience of one's own self by whatever means you describe that as: true self, actual self, higher self, lower self, whatever you want to call that self as. It's you in your existence, which has some singularity in how you progress. So much can be described there because that's the first 2 hours of sunset. To give you a means to practice it, there is a place, and you use that one every hour of the day, every minute, every second. Even while you sleep, you're having that experience. So becoming aware of that you have a feeling-oriented existence as self. Some people can call that the I am. You can call that consciousness. You can call that awareness. You can call that conscience. You can call it whatever the adjectives you want to call it, but it exists as you. And it is inalienable. It cannot be possessed. It cannot be destroyed. It cannot be lost because it will always exist. It has all kinds of challenges about how to be able to become aware of it and use it better, but it's connected to the one above it. The one right above it is like 8 p.m. to 10 p.m., and that corresponds to that part of the evening or the day when you leave the material dimension or you leave your mind and you go into a higher dimension. Yeah, I know that sounds like wild science fiction, but the reality is every night when you go to bed, you're not in your body. You may come and go from it, depending on your body chemistry, your feelings, your age, and so on. But every single night, your feeling existence goes into this part where it goes into a metamorphosis. You go into the dark, sometimes it's fearful, it goes into a transformation, and you can go into a higher world. That higher world is like the ability to be able to go from sunset where you can't see the stars, and it gets dark when you. When it gets dark, you can see the stars. The same thing is happening to you all the time. These three are an instrument. They're always with you. So what is it also? It's called self, others, and all. Now, inside this picture, you can see the same three: self, others, and all. The bottom of this has to do with your feelings about your mother's side of the family. And the top half, self, others, and all, about your father's family, or it's inner spiritual world, which also encompasses the mind, or its outer social physical manifestation world, and so on and so on and so on. We're always circulating in and out of this, and we're always using self, others, and all. Now, why I'm telling you this now is I've been really spending time on the month of November going into December in the six girl. Now, all that means it's every one of these numbers is just an identity to a gland, an organ, a body system, or a chakra function. This is the top of the brain. This is the pineal. And the pineal is that part that people love with their psilocybin and ayahuasca and the DMT functions and MDMA. It opens upper vision. Those visions, by the way, they happen to do with biochemical functions happening within the brain. But the actual function of this one, six girl, is to open the upper boundaries of consciousness in its capacity to receive something from above. By whatever you want to describe that thing above, you can call it level eight, you can call it being one with God, you can call it higher consciousness. It's all kinds of things you can call it, because you can call it what you want. You can call it the presence of the Holy Spirit. You can call it snow or frost. You can call it lots of things. Eternal pristine silence. It's pretty cool. There's lots there. It's regulated by an interior experience of how you hold your attitude or your belief systems currently about what the all is. Some people say, I'm the all, we're all the all, there's the all, there is no all. But you do have a current belief system about your all. That's connected to your ability for transformation. Six girl, four girl. Four girl is the ability to morph. Change. So your ability to change is oftentimes when you go into the sleep state and you leave your physical body, you're going into the opportunity to morph, to change, to grow, to let go, to reorganize, to heal, whatever you want to call it. Self, others, and all. Just ponder that for a moment. Now, when you go to each one of these, yes, it's belly brain, it's heart brain, it's head brain. These are three different organizational functions of self, others, and all. Inside this image, all this image is the passage of time. If you go right here, this is called basically coming into sunset. Right there, when it crosses over, where my fingers are, that's sunset. That's also equivalent to an equinox. And now it goes into the evening and the nighttime, comes out, and inspiration goes up, and there is sunrise, goes up and around, and yes, the same cycle happens in a heartbeat, in a breath, in a step, in a month, in a year, in 10,000 years, the same pattern is occurring. It's holographic. Now, inside of this is self, others, and all. How I treat myself in reality, how I treat others, how I treat the all. Now, 99.9% of the time, we're not very aware of the reality of how these three are interfaced with each other. And how the inner world is actually creating the outer world. Because we have lots of layers of powdered dust of self-image, facade, mask, persona, projections, escapism, doubt, self-sabotage, you name it, guilt, shame, hopelessness, despair, or projection, or optimisms, and all the things that we do that are outrageous and arrogant and progressive. Self, others, and all. These three are always with you. Just every now and then, just pause. How am I feeling about myself right now? How am I actually interfacing with other people, others? That others, by the way, is huge. You can't go into the upper dimensions without actually learning how to ride your tricycle in your kindergarten of dealing with others. Others is an essential part of it. But you can't do the others without occupying the experience of yourself, self, others, and all. And they're always circulating. What's really unique is that the 3 months of the autumn combines these three and gives you the opportunity to open a small gate at the top of your skull or consciousness, fontanelle, if you want, or at the top of your heart or the top of your belly, right where your navel is. It gives you the ability to be able to open one of these gates or all of them and have a tiny mist-like droplet of divine nectar touch your pineal, touch your heart, touch your belly, self, others, and all. So there are treasures happening in this third month of the autumn season. I urge you just to let the snow fall on your face. Self, others, and all. Enjoy.